So we're gonna take this piece off, and I'm gonna probably drill a hole in it, like right here, okay? And then I'm gonna thread this piece in there, make it real tight. And then I'm gonna run this clear line from there over to the pulse pump, which is what you got. That's gonna bolt to the top of that bracket, because the bracket's gonna be standing up here, so it's gonna have a nice little flat spot to sit. Like that. Look at that, you don't even have to drill it out.
It's perfect.
All right, so you're gonna clean it up. I'm gonna give you some hardware, and you'll pick out some bolts and just mount it here with some washers and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'll drill out for the overhead valve cover and run a line from here. See if this line's gonna be long enough.
Yeah, it looks.
If not, I got some other line. Basically. That's gonna go to there.
Yeah, it's that'll perfect.
Work. Right, so it's gonna go to the P. Alright. When you go to give it some gas. Hear that?
Yeah.
That's the issue I'm having with it. But I pulled this line off before, no gas came out to you. Oh, that looks pretty clean. You can see the little bit of water in it.
Is that what that is?
Leftover water bottle.
Milk?
Yep. Yeah. Because the water separates from the gas. Comes out of this hole when the engine's running, and I was like, well, how's the air getting there, you know, because the valves come up and push air. Well, look here.
Oh,
it's got like a little
Snapple bottle,
a little valve for it, and it blows air out. So I don't know what it looks like inside here, so I'm taking a gamble drilling a hole here. I just have to clean it out real good.
Do you think drilling the hole will mess with how that functions?
Well, I'm just worried about like pieces of metal getting down in there and then being blown back into the carburetor.
Is there a way to drill that out and just blow it all out? Like with
I'd have to drill here and cover this up like with some tape and then just blow all this out, that way nothing gets in there, and just put it right here. But if I put it here, I don't know if it's gonna clear the valves. pulse, and I got my fuel. So put that bracket on next with the pulse pump. Pour over and let you clean up that spot on the frame.
Okay.
And then we're just ready to weld it in place and mount everything. I got the aluminum.
Do you want me to make that line a little cleaner, or is that fine?
That's perfect. So, what we'll do is, I would get you to, I'll give you a glove.
Uh-huh.
And you can hold it right here.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of where I'm going to touch that. Yeah, because that's kind of
going to start ready? That. Now I'm ready.
Off. Here we go. I keep holding it. Alright, should be able to let it go.
Yes.
Yep. Get closer to it. Alright, hold on a minute.
Sorry.
Plenty of footage of me struggling.
Oh, it's a depressor together on both sides of the tire.
Yep. Yeah, so instead of having to fit that tire over like we did in that one video, and we push it all over, we can just take this apart, split it, and then put the tire on. You know where this goes?
This one?
That one that says P.
Is it P?
There's a little P right there. See the P right there? And then I wrote N right there because I'm
right here. Alright. Alright. Pulse is gonna go here. Alright. Now we need a little short piece of fuel line to go from here to right here. Carburetor. So I need a piece that goes from here to here. Preferably like, maybe like that, so it doesn't get near the muffler. I might can drill a hole there and put a zip tie.
Yeah, we'll do that. Zip tie certified. I think I want this kind of out of the way.
See if I can stop this gas leak.